वेलकम टू एग्रीकल्चरल डेवलपमेंट ट्रस्ट शारदा बाई पवार महिला आर्ट्स कॉमर्स साइंस कॉलेज शारदा नगर बारामती। आई एम प्रोफेसर पूनम मिश्रा, ब्रॉट फॉर यू द सब्जेक्ट सेक्रेटरियल प्रैक्टिस इन विच वी आर लर्निंग द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ कंपनी। सो स्टूडेंट्स, in the third chapter, that is formation of company, we will learn how any company is registered or incorporated and when any company come into an existence or when it is legally acceptable. So student, before moving further, we should understand what is company. A company is an artificial legal person. It is a artificial, it's not a natural person, it's a creation by the law, so that's why it is called as a artificial legal person. Why legal person? Because it is created by the legal procedure or following the law of the Companies Act. It comes into existence when it is registered by following the procedure laid down by the Companies Act 2013. The company comes into existence means it gain the status in the market when they follow the procedure which is given by the Companies Act. Formation of a company means registering or incorporating a company with the registrar of company. Now students, you must be knowing who are the registrar of company. Registrar of company are the offices or the controller of the all legal formalities of every company. In every locality, there must be one registrar office where all the companies will file their legal document. In the state where the company's registered office is to be located, so there must be one registrar of company's office in every state where the all document of or the legal proceeding of the companies are filed with them as a record. Registrar of company, ROC, is a authority as per the Companies Act which can incorporate the company. Means the authority or the right is given to the registrar of company to make birth of any company or to make the registration of any company. Students, here are the three steps for creation or formation of a company. First one is a promotion. Students, promotion means the initial step which is taken by the person or the group of person for the following the legal procedure of the company. In the stage of promotion, two or more than two person come together, they follow all the legal proceeding, they follow all the formality for coming into existence a company as a legal institution. So promotion is a very essential or very initial stage of the birth of any company or the creation of the company. Next is an incorporation of company. This is the main stage where the company legally get registered with the registrar of company. And after the incorporation, the company can start its business. Then the third step is a commencement of business. Means after registering, the company or the institution can start their business. Here we will learn how and what are the stages for the registration or steps are undertaken to incorporate a company. You can see here, students, the first stage for registration or incorporation of company is obtain digital signature certificate. Now you know students, digital signature is just a signature like we are a human being and like a natural person, and we are a natural person, so we have our own signature. Like that only the company must have its own signature. So company's first step for the incorporation is that they should get authorized, or they should get authenticated digital means online technical signature, so that they can use that signature for the further procedure or for further any transaction with the other parties on online basis. Next is a register, DSC, digital signature certificate in the name of director with MCA. MCA we have learned earlier, MCA is Ministry of Corporate Affairs, who takes care all type of company, and they make the rules and regulation to be followed in all types of industry and corporate. Next is obtain director identification number, which is very important. Next is apply for reservation of name, finalization of memorandum and articles of association. We know, student, what is the memorandum. Memorandum is a rules book for any company, or the all details of a company or the business, who are the promoters, what are the objectives, what are the rules, what is the authorized share capital, how many members are there. All these information will be included in memorandum of association. Articles of association consist the internal rules and regulation of a company that we have learned in the earlier chapters in detail. Next is signing, stamping and dating of the memorandum. Whatever the memorandum and articles of association, whenever it is created, that should be signed, stamped and dated with the all the directors of the company are the higher authority of the management. Next is prepare the other necessary documents. After that, the company will prepare the other necessary document. They will decide their address, registered address, which should be mentioned or which should be filed with the registrar of company for any further communication. Next is obtain a statutory declaration. They will ask for the legal declaration from the specific authority, then filing the application and document for incorporation with the ROC, and finally they will file all the document for the registration or incorporation of the company to ROC. Filing the application and document for the incorporation with ROC, and again application and documentation will be filed with the ROC. Students, those points we will see in detail here. The first step is obtaining digital signature certificate. A digital signature certificate is needed for the person authorized to sign the document for e-filing. E-filing means whenever the company will make the transaction on online basis or in a computerized form, or that is known as a e-filing. So at that time the company will use their digital signature for authentication, for the proof that the transaction is being done by this company only. So it is very important. So promoters, the initial person who promote or who does all the formality for incorporation of the company is known as a promoter. So promoter are the person who propose the first director need to obtain the DSC, means promoter will be the first can be the first director of the company, and they will do all the formality for getting the digital signature certificate of the company by applying to the certified authority, that is digital signature certificate. It is a signature of a person in digital or electronic form. It is used to sign on e-document. Next is a registered DSC in the name of director with the MCA. So that whatever the digital signature is received or obtained by the company, that will be registered in the name of the director of the company with the Ministry of Corporate Affairs with the MCA. So after obtaining the DSC, the name of the promoter or director has to be registered with the MCA, means all the name will be registered or will be attached to that digital signature certificate. MCA maintains the detail of every directors, including their DIN, personal detail, etc. So Ministry of Corporate Affairs maintains their details of every directors, including their director identification number and personal details. So Ministry of Corporate Affairs are the highest or the topmost authority for controlling and managing the all corporate companies or industries. Next is obtain director identification number. Once the company has obtained their DSC and that DSC is attached with the name of director with MCA, the third step of the company is for incorporation, that the director of that company should get their DIN, director identification number. The proposed first director or the first director of the company who do not have the DIN, that is director identification number, they have to apply for the DIN in the electronic form, means online basis, at the time of incorporation. A person to be appointed as a director must have a DIN. So whoever the person will be appointed as a director of that company, they must have the director identification number. After that, fourth step is apply for the reservation of name. Once the directors will get their DIN, so next step is apply for the reservation name of the company. The promoter or the director have to decide the name of that company. So the promoter have to get the proposed name of the company approved by the Central Registration Center CRC by filing the run reserve unique name along with the prescribed fee through MCA portal. So MCA has given the portal, that is www.mca.gov.in, on which the company can file to the CRC, that is Central Registration Center, to reserve their unique name with them. Next is finalize Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association. And after that, student finalize, the company will finalize what should be mentioned in the Memorandum of Association and what should be the rule for the internal processing. So in the Memorandum of Association, all the details of that company, like the company's objective, that company's corporate identity number, how many directors are there, their name, registered address, how many members are there, their name and registered member, authorized capital, registered office of the company, objectives and aim of the company, all these incorporation related detail will be mentioned in the Memorandum of Association, and that will be signed by the directors and members. All the directors investment or in shares and members investment in the shares and debenture, whatever they belongs to, will be mentioned in the Memorandum of Association, and it will be signed by all director, member and secretary. And in finalization of articles of association, the company will decide how their internal work will go on. They will make some rule, procedure and stages to be followed for continuing the business activity, that will be written in the articles of association. And all these two documents have to be submitted along with the application of incorporation of the company, and this document contain the legal and technical information related to the objectives of the company, regulation for the operation of the company pursuant to the company law. Hence the promoter take the help of professional like a company secretary. Means the promoter will prepare the memorandum and articles of association with the help of the professional. And who are those professional? Those are company secretary, legal expert, chartered accountant. They will help to finalize the memorandum and articles of association, and after finalizing it, that will be signed, stamped and dated. So when once the memorandum of association and articles of association is being created and it is finalized, after that, that should be signed by each subscriber, means all the members, director and secretary and shareholders. So and with their name and description, address and occupations. So in the presence of the at least one witness who shall attest the signature and likewise sign and add his name, description, address and occupation. So all the document, all the memorandum and articles of association will be signed, dated and stamped. After that, seventh stage is preparation of necessary document which is needed, which is required for incorporating a company. So first one is a consent of director. Consent of director means the company should take the permission of director for preparing the document. A list of person who have agreed to be the first director along with their written consent, means the person who are ready to become the first director of the company, they have to give the consent, they have to give the proof in written that they are ready to become the director of the company, and their personal detail like their DIN and their identity proof, their interest in the firm or the company should be included in the list, and the required written consent and agreement should be in the prescribed format as per the Companies Act. So in the seven stages, first is that the all directors should be agreed, they should sign with their director identification number and their ID proof that they are ready to become a director of this particular company. Next is details of manager, secretary. So next step for preparing the necessary document is that the details of company's manager and secretary should be mentioned. So if the articles of association names a person who will be the manager and secretary, etc., particulars of such person should be prepared for filing purposes. So like directors, the manager and secretary's detail will be also prepared and listed, and it will be filed to the registrar of company. Next is declaration by subscriber to the memorandum and first director. So subscriber of memorandum means the person who is signing the memorandum. And who will sign the memorandum of association? The person who is related to the company, or the person who is a member of the company, or director of the company, or secretary, or the manager of the company. Those person will sign and declare that I am the member, secretary, manager of this company. So a declaration should be taken from each subscriber to the memorandum of association, and every person named as a first director in the articles of association that he is not convicted of any offense, means they have not done any crime. Offense means crime in the connection with the promotion, means they are accepting that we have not done any offense, we have not done any illegal things for the promotion, means initial promotion of the company or the formation or management of the company, and he has not been found guilty of any fraud, dishonesty and breach of any duty to any company during preceding 5 years. So they also agree, they also declare that we have not found anyone as a guilty in respect of fraud, cheating, dishonesty, means not unloyal or breach. They have not done any, they have not broken any law or duty of the company in preceding 5 years. In preceding 5 years means in last 5 years. So they also have to give an undertaking that all the document filed with the registrar of company are correct, complete and true. So here they, all the member will declare that they are not a criminal, they are not found guilty in the last 5 years, and they are they have filed all the document to the register of company. Those document are very correct, complete and true. Next is address for communication and notice of registered office address. So company will decide which address should be used as a registered address and on which all the communication should be, by which all the communication of the company should be done. So at the time of incorporation, if the proposed company has not decided the location of registered office, the promoter have to give an address for communication. Means if at the time of incorporation the address is not finalized, after that the promoter have to give an address as per the Companies Act, and the company is required to have the registered office within 30 days of the incorporation. So this is the important line, student, please try to by head it. Next is obtain a statutory declaration form, legal declaration form. An advocate, practicing company secretary, or the cost accountant or chartered accountant who is engaged in the formation of the company, and a person named in the articles of association as a director, manager, secretary, stating that all requirement related to the incorporation has been complied with. Means these are the person like director, manager and secretary who will declare that all the things which is done for the formation of the company are done on a legal basis, and it is signed and stamped by the practicing company secretary, CA, chartered accountant and any lawyer that is advocate. So it will be the legal or statutory declaration. Last, filling the application and document for the incorporation of the company, and then filing the application. Finally, the company will file the application with the all required document for the incorporation of a company. So after all documents are prepared, the promoter have to submit an application to the register of company in a prescribed form along with the all necessary document and prescribed fees for the incorporation. Last is obtaining certificate of incorporation. Finally, the company will obtain or receive the certificate of incorporation after verifying that all the document and information submitted to it is a proper, and the registrar of companies will enter the name of the company in register of companies and certified under his hand that the company is incorporated. So after verifying the document, ROC, registrar of company, will certified under the Companies Act, will enter the name of the company and certified in the hand of that it is the company which is incorporated. Registrar issue the certificate of incorporation in a prescribed form, means in a well-defined form. So what are the details will be there in the incorporation of the company, certificate of incorporation of the company? First, the name of the company. Next, date of issue of certificate of incorporation. Third one is corporate identity number. Like we have our permanent account number, Aadhaar number, all the company has their corporate identity number, permanent account number, TAN number, and signature of registrar with the date and his seal. Seal means the company stamp and signature. Okay, so students, hope you understood all the stages for the formation or the incorporation of the company, which is very important from this chapter. So students, meet you in the next video very soon. Thank you.